Praise the Lord, everybody. I do not own the rights to the song that just played. I do not own the rights to the song. I do not own the rights to the song. God bless you. How you doing, everybody? God bless you. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. My name is Sister Vanessa, and I appreciate you joining me. We're going to get your Bibles out. We're getting ready to get in our Bible study. It's going to be 2 Kings chapter 1, and we're going to talk about a king, the northern king in Israel. And he is the king, the capital of Israel. This is the northern kingdom, it's Samaria. Okay, praise God. And Ahaziah, I might be pronouncing his name wrong, but I'm going to try to get it right. We're going to talk about him, how he didn't seek the Lord. He had a bad illness. He fell off. We're going to read what he fell. He got hurt real bad. Let's read into the lesson. Before we do, I have a few announcements. This Sunday, I'll be teaching Sunday school on gospel at my church, Gospel True Light Church of God in Christ. But I'll be teaching on my Facebook. We know my Facebook, Vanessa McClendon. And thank the Lord. And at 12 o'clock, my pastor will be ministering, Superintendent Elder Reginald Bradley. He'll be ministering on Gospel True Light Church of God in Christ at 12 o'clock. On Tuesday, we have Prayer and Bible Band, Mother Costa will be teaching, and this is just a temporary, she's teaching until the First Lady recovers. She had an ankle surgery, so just keep her in your prayers. She's doing well, but keep her in your prayers. The Lord is blessing. And my pastor will be joining Mother Costa as she's teaching. Praise God. So our lesson, we're going to pray, and we're going to get into the lesson. And it's another interesting lesson. The whole Bible is interesting. Father, we just thank you for your goodness and mercy. We thank you for your love, God, and joy. Open up all our understanding of your word. Lord God, have your way. Let the word be applied to my heart, that it might not sin against thee. Look out on the audience, those that are listening. Lord, touch the needs. Oh God, you're the one that heals thee. Lord, we just thank you for all your goodness and your mercy, your love, and all things, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. And just thank you for putting your arm of protection up on us with this virus going. And those that are sick, Lord God, you're the one that heal it, Lord God. You're the one that people can have all the medicine, everything in the world. But you're the one that bring forth healing. Thank the Lord. Thank God for the knowledge for the shot that people take. But you're the one that caused to put that barrier that from people from getting as sick, if they pray, thanks the Lord, that take the shot. But you know, our hope and trust is in the Lord. It's not, we take the shot, we should. Our hope and trust is in you. Oh God, we thank you for all things. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to get this together. Okay, now, verse 1 of 2 Kings reads us this. And then Moab, you know, Moab is the descent, is one of, ascended from Lot. And we know that the Moab, one of his daughters, had an incestuous relationship with the father and had people. This is a race of people called Moab. And this Moab people, they rebelled against Israel after the death of Ahab. We know Ahab was a wicked king. He married Jezebel. He's very wicked. And he died. And his son is taking his place in the northern kingdom. I'm not pronouncing it right, but I'm going to get it. Okay, he was the son of Ahab and Jezebel, and they were among the most wicked. You know, Ahab and Jezebel was about the most wicked rulers they ever had. And Ahaziah, that's his name, thank God, Ahaziah, his parents, they brought Baal worship, demonic worship, false gods and false worship into the land, and turned God's people away from God. Although Ahaziah, Ahaziah reigned for two, he only reigned for 2 years. He was just as evil as his parents. And he arose that he made the Lord angry. You know, God is angry at the wicked every day. You know, I tell you, the way of a transgression is hard. Bible says, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, for I give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I'm meek and lowly in heart. You find rest for your soul. You know, when Jesus comes in our heart, God gives us rest. Rest in him. But the way of a transgression is hard. And it says here, due to his own worship, because he was, the reason why God was upset with him, because he, due to his own worship of Baal, praise God, these other nations were worshiping Baal, false god, which continued to lead the people into sin and to idolatry. It's idolatry, worshiping any other god before, you put anything before the Lord, it's idolatry, praise the Lord. And so, 2 Kings, the second version, Ahaziah fell down through a lattice in the upper chamber that was in Samaria. That's where he lived. And he was sick. He got hurt real bad. And he sent messengers away to try to inquire. Let me read the rest of the verse. And he sent messengers and said unto the messengers, go inquire Beelzebub, the god of Ekron. This is a Philistine god. Whether I shall recover of this disease. So this man, he was wicked. God was angry with him. And he said he fell down and got hurt real, real bad off an upper chamber. It says a lattice. Praise God. So this is a window or something. He fell down. Praise God. And he sent some people to inquire of Beelzebub. This is the demonic. The Beelzebub is, I think it's called the Lord of the Flies, and the God of Ekron, whether I shall recover or not. So, praise the Lord. So, Ahaziah, okay. So, at some point during the reign of Ahaziah, King Ahaziah of Israel, this is what, remember that we know during the time of Solomon's son, I believe it's Jeroboam, and Jeroboam and his son, I can't think of his name. Rehoboam. Thank you, Jesus. Rehoboam was Solomon's son. During the time of that time period, they broke up. The kingdom split into two, and this is going further down. But we in a lot. We know that Ahab had passed. Okay, he died, and so now this is his son reigning. So at this point, so what that king did, he fell out of a window. And injured himself so bad, and he couldn't move. He was confined to the bed, and rather than get repent, that's the time to get it right. Even though he was wicked, but get it right with the Lord. Rather than inquire of the Lord, he didn't ask. There was a prophet there. There was Elisha was there, but he didn't inquire of the Lord. He went over and sent someone to talk to this false. To the Beelzebub, go inquire of him to see if he'll be all right. Demonic, false gods, and so the Lord sent his prophet Elijah. Elijah, praise the Lord. You know, this is Elijah. When I read about Elijah, he brings. You get faith come by hearing by the word of God. When I look at how the Lord used him mightily, and you know he was man like just like us, like passion like us. But God used him mightily because you have to have faith. That's what moves God. But the Lord sent his prophet Elijah to him, praise God, to confront the messengers. He went to those messengers that the king had sent to inquire of that demonic, of the demonic Beelzebub, cry out to the false gods. And so Elijah confronted the messengers, and he gave them the message that God gave him for Ahaziah, the king, and he told him the message that king would never recover from his injury and would die in his bed. And so, 2 and 3, and the angel of the Lord said to Elijah, so the angel of the Lord, which is the Lord, praise God, said to Elijah, the Tishbe, go to meet the messenger of the king of Samaria. So we read that. That's what happened. And just tell them what the Lord, this is what the Lord said. Is it not because there is not a God in Israel? There is a God in Israel that you go to inquire of Beelzebub, the God of Akron. I think it's Lord of the, Beelzebub is the Lord of the flies. Praise God. Praise God. And the prince of devils, and another name for the devil. Praise God. Praise God. So the angel is often believed to be the second member of the Trinity, which is Jesus Christ himself. So, praise God. So, verse 4, now therefore, thus said the Lord, thou shalt not, this is what the Lord gave him, let him know, tell those, thou shalt not come down from the bed on which thou art gone up, but thou shalt surely die. You know, surely means guarantee. And Elijah departed. He confronted those messengers. He gave what message the Lord gave him to give. Praise the God. The angel of the Lord, which is the Lord, which is the Lord Jesus. And you know, in the Bible saying, the volume of the book is written to me to do thy will, O God. So every book in the Old Testament, the volume of the book is it's speaking about Jesus. It's speaking about the Lord. 5, and when the messengers turned back, they went back. Went back to the king. And he said to them, why are you back? So one of the wise said, why are ye now turned back? Why are you coming back? You know, because I guess he's expecting them to take a little while to go talk to that false guy. 6, and they said to him, there was a man up in to meet us and said to us, go turn away unto the king that sent you. You turn away and say to him, I want you to tell that king, this is what Elijah told them to turn back. And I want you to tell that king, thus said the Lord, it is not because there is not a God in Israel that thou sentest to inquire of Beelzebub, the king of Ekron. I think when I say Ekron, I think about the Philistines, their God. Therefore, thou shalt not come down from the bed on which thou art gone up, and thou shalt surely die. And then this is what the king said to those men. And he said to them, verse 7, what manner of man was he which came up to meet you? And he told them, and he told you these words. You know, wonder who, you know, what did he look like? The person that told you these words. And they said to him, he was a hairy man, describing Elijah. A girded, he had a belt, he had girded with a girdle of leather around his loins. So he had a belt around his waist and said unto, and he said, it is Elijah the Tishbite. Praise the Lord. Sounds, you know, when he heard that, he was laying, he couldn't move. He had to stay in bed. He was messed up. He was in bad shape from that fall. And then he asked those people, those messengers, to describe him. And that's not, and the man gave him the message that God gave them through Elijah. That sounds like repentant time to me. When you get that kind of bad report, but he, so verse 9, then the king sent unto him, he said he's going to send his armies to go get that man, which is Elijah. And so the king sent unto him a captain of 50 men, and he went up to them, to Elijah. And behold, he sat up on a hill. Elijah was sitting on a hill, and he spake unto him. This is what captain of the 50 men that was with him said, thou man of God, the king has said, come down. And Elijah said unto the captain of the 50, the men, he's talking back, if I be a man of God, then let fire come down from heaven and consume thee and thy 50. And there came down from heaven that consumed his 50. This is the first group. They died. This is another group that the king sent out to get Elijah to come to him. Again, as he, verse 11, again, as he sent unto him another captain of 50 with his 50. And he answered and said to him, which is to Elijah, O man of God, thus has the king said, come down quickly. So the man told him, the captain of the guard said, come down quickly, Elijah. And verse 12, And Elijah answered and said unto them, If I be a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and consume thee and thy 50. And fire, this is the second group of 50. And the fire of God came down from heaven and consumed them and his 50. And so that was, that's 100 men. So this is a 13. And he went again, and a captain of the third 50 and his 50, and the captain and the third captain of 50 went up and came and fell on his knees before Elijah. He humbled himself, because the other two groups, they died. The fire, okay, from heaven. And besought him. He besought him and said to him, oh, this is to Elijah, this is the captain. O man of God, I pray thee, let my life and the life of these 50 servants be precious in thy sight. He humbled himself and begged. He talked to Elijah and begged him and prayed thee, let my life, let it be precious in the life of these 50 in thy sight. Praise the Lord. And you know, number three, this is the third time. And the three is completeness, meaning of completeness. So it's 14, behold, there came from heaven, there came fire from, and behold, there came fire down from heaven and burnt up the other two captains and the former 50s and their 50s. So he said, this is what this captain is telling them. Now fire came from heaven, burned the other 50s. Therefore, let my life now be precious in thy sight. Lord, let our life be precious in your sight. Because this is what happened in the other two groups of men. And the angel of the Lord, he's listening to the Lord, you know. You have to listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches, but listen to what the Lord is, when the Lord is speaking to you. And so the Lord, angel of the Lord said unto Elijah, go down with him. So the angel of the Lord, he's listening to the Lord. The Lord is speaking to Elijah. Let him know, you go down with him and be not afraid of him. Don't be afraid of the king. Pray, don't be afraid of him at all. And he arose up and he went down with the king. He listened to the voice of the Lord. That's what we got to do. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. It reproves the world of sin, convicts us, and let us know, lead us and guide us in all truth. 2 Kings, verse 16. And he said unto him, thus said the Lord, forasmuch as thou hast sent messengers to inquire of Beelzebub. So he's talking to the king now. Praise God. He's talking to the king, Ahaziah. Praise the Lord. Ahaziah, the king. And 16. And he said unto him, thus said the Lord, forasmuch as thou hast sent messengers, you sent messengers to inquire of Beelzebub, which is the god of Ekron. Is it not because there is no God in Israel to inquire of his word? Therefore thou shalt not come down from the bed. Since you wouldn't inquire of the Lord, you wouldn't ask God for healing, you wouldn't inquire of the Lord at all. You went out and sent people to see about sent these people to a false god, which they didn't end up going to because Elijah interrupted their on the way. He let them know what thus said the Lord. Praise the Lord. Is it not because there is no God in Israel? You didn't inquire of the Lord. Therefore thou shalt not come, you're not going to come down from the bed on which thou hast gone up, but thou shalt surely die. When something you see surely, it means guarantee you're going to die. And that was time to cry out like Elijah. It's time. I know Hezekiah cried out, you know, and God gave him 15 more years. Praise the Lord. You hadn't asked the Lord about your situation, you know, about your ailment. Praise God. He would not seek the Lord. Praise God. So we see, we're going to finish this, and then we're going to talk about someone else, Asa. He's a good king, and he didn't seek the Lord. About his feet, we had diseases, but we was going to briefly, we won't say too much about him, just very little. And so he wouldn't seek the Lord. So what happened, verse 17 says, I can see, when you see surely, it means guaranteed. So he died according to the word of the Lord, which Elijah had spoken. God gave him, the angel of the Lord, which is the Lord Jesus, gave him, I know, praise the Lord. The angel of the Lord spoke to him. And Jehoram reigned in his stead the second year of Joram, the son of Jehoshaphat, king of Judah. Praise the Lord. Okay, so, and then verse 12, 2 Kings, 2 Chronicles 16 and 12, now there was another king. He was, his name is Asa. He was a godly king. He loved the Lord. Praise God. But he ended up having, later on in life, he had diseases in his feet. And his, until he, his feet got so in bad shape, they would say they were diseased so exceedingly great. But he didn't seek the Lord on it. Praise the Lord. He did, what he did, he sought physicians. He sought, and we're supposed to go and ask for, see the doctor. But that we have to seek the Lord. Because God is the one that heals. He's the one that healeth thee. He blessed people to come and have knowledge. But this is a godly king, and Asa. But the other man wasn't godly. Ahaziah was not godly at all. That's the one that was the son of Ahab and Jezebel. The one that we talked to earlier who had fell from the lattice. Praise the Lord. And he was in bad shape. But this man, later on in another scripture, Asa, the king of good, that godly king, wouldn't seek the Lord. We had to seek the Lord. We had to acknowledge him and everything that goes on. And God, since he didn't seek the Lord, he was trusting in human being, trusting in the physician here. And it says here, verse 2 Chronicles 16 and 12, and he was 30. Thank God. And so he was in bad shape. Feet just getting worse and worse. Wouldn't see, and the Bible said, would not seek the Lord, but he just put his confidence in people. I thank the Lord for the shots that we get and things, but we got to put our confidence and trust in the Lord because men will fail you. Praise the Lord. God bless you, Sister Vanessa. Lord's willing, this is a little short broadcast. Keep me in your prayers. God bless you. Bye-bye. See you next Wednesday. Lord, say so. Bye-bye.